Welcome to the General's Gentlemen.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Water's World. We have everyone's favorite North American Company of Heroes 2 player.
Yeah, Brocious.
Shadow Water.
Oh, okay, right. No.
Awkward.
Awkward. I like Shadow a lot. He's a dude that I like that is cool, and we will be casting him today. His opponent will be a Brocious as our OKW.
Yeah, I have no idea where this guy is from. So if he is from America, then he might be offended by our favoritism.
He could be. There's a chance.
You know, I think it's an objective truth that Shadow Water is objectively everyone's favorite US player.
I guess that's true. See, Red Wings is from Canada, isn't he? Is Red Wings Canadian?
I don't remember.
I don't 100% remember.
We've got through
Bro,
so many casts
I'm
today
sorry, man.
Without
better,
me having my Facebook
you
sounds
mute
on.
Your Facebook right now.
I can just close it. Because the great
thing
is because we're not casting Company of Heroes, we're not casting Zero Hour, it means that I can do this crazy thing called minimize, and it doesn't break my game.
It's a big plus. We really like it. So, standard opening here. Kubel out for Brocious. He's also going for another squad of Volks after this as well. So nothing too crazy to start off this game. All standard builds.
Yeah, two Volks. He's actually putting some sandbags. Good spot there with the sandbags. I love that. We'll allow him to hold the munitions point. As long as he doesn't get hit by the garrison. So maybe he'll race for the garrison.
I think wiring off the entrance. Trying to wire off the entrance to the church as well. I'm not sure if... I think you...
Oh, yeah.
Can you do that? Is one wire enough there, or do you need more than that?
I'm not
I
sure,
feel like
actually.
You would need a couple.
Because
but...
you can warp through obstacles to get to it.
Yeah, which is probably
sure.
Why he's angled the wire vertically.
Yeah.
To make sure there's as much blockage as possible, but yeah. I'd be interested to see if that actually works. I haven't seen that particular reinforced wire strap before to block up the entrance to the church, so we'll see.
We got out of it.
He got out of it, so...
But I'm not
sure.
That's
no guarantee whether you can get in and out, though. It does change. The warps are strange and different. And a nice play from Shadow Water actually flanks around the side and manages to secure the house.
It was after he capped his fuel point, so he didn't see that one coming. So other than that, we're going to have the Stim Pioneers charging up to this S. I'm trying to go for the house. The Rifleman will probably get it, though. He has to vault the heavy cover there. But no, turns to engage the Echelon instead, trying to wipe those down. Whoops, I've turned the... Oh, how do I get rid of the... Okay, got it. Cool. I was playing around with the Observer hotkeys before we started this game. Just in case we forget who our US player is, we can bring up that handy... The text to remind us.
Very helpful. It's just so confusing sometimes. Like, is this a squad of Volsk? Is it a squad of Riflemen? I mean, who knows? It's just very confusing for everyone involved. Volks Grenadier, ready for action. So still having decent map control here. Smart capping with the Kubel. Keeping that out of too many engagements and moving him with the Stim Pioneers.
Oh, Stim Pioneers, though, going to be charging through negative cover. Kubel as well is firing, but the Stim Pioneers are getting completely wrecked there. Maybe if they were along the left side where they were outside of the negative cover, but even then, they were pretty low and didn't have a lot of chance of winning that one. So it's the mortar here, being rushed out by Shadow Water. Not a surprise at all to see. We'll help him clear out this garrison, nothing else.
Yeah, very potent is the 81mm mortar from the USF at the moment. As the machine sorts, would you say more than potent machine?
No,
say,
I was laughing at the Kubel.
Right.
See how it turned like really quickly?
I didn't see that.
Sometimes the vehicles, like, you know how they spin out really quickly?
Yeah.
Sometimes the vehicles just have these weird moments, and that's what the Kubel did just then. So we have two Volks here,
full
health.
They probably have some zero-hour technical, like, in their in their bloodlines, so that would make sense.
The DNA.
The DNA of the zero-hour technical.
The genetic ancestry.
Yep. Zero is an older RTS game, man. It totally works. I certainly follow that line of thinking.
Oh, mechanized truck here. See, I don't know about this because Brocious, he hasn't really had the fuel advantage. The way I see it is going for a Panzer II is amazing, but if you don't have the fuel advantage, then your opponent can often just counter that. So what do we have here from Shadow Water? He's got his captain out.
Yeah, so it will be the steward eventually here. And it might not be the P2.
Well, it's either that or a Puma.
You know, why not just go battle group, I guess you could say. But I guess the Puma and assume the Stuart's going to come back, which it will eventually, probably from Shadow Water. So it can work.
And the Puma out early. The Puma is great and all against infantry, or against vehicles. I mean, against a Stuart or a AA half track, for example. But the problem with that then is then you just don't have any medics, and then you just will lose every infantry engagement because, you know, unless you're using the medical crates, which is a munitions bleed. He doesn't even have Vet 1 on his Sturms. So we'll have to see how it goes. Going for a Panzer 2 is a bit easier though, or a Puma as well, because there isn't the bazooka anymore on the Captain. You have to unlock one of them. But it means that they are an effective squad in the early game with the Thompson out and those four rifles. Did he get STGs during that engagement?
It was too late though. It was like kind of as he was retreating, so last second.
Yeah.
The STGs. They were there a little bit earlier. Might have mattered a little bit with the Jaegers being popped here from the garrison. I think Bruce was actually only just got the CPs necessary to pop that squad out.
Spawned some Jaegers from that house. Gonna be forcing those rifles away. Getting the cutoff taken, and this is so important, losing the cutoff against the mechanized player. So Shadow Water can almost afford his Stuart, just needs 10 more fuel, and that Stuart, it counters the Panzer II so hard because it has the stun rounds.
Yeah, it certainly is a very rough engagement for the Panzer II. Captain actually only just got away from the top engagement. Very low.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I didn't think it was that close. Obviously retreated past the Jaegers and they got a bit of work done. I do like Jaeger play against USF. They trade quite nicely if you can get behind decent cover. They won't go that well here, though.
Up close, though, they're not very effective. They're more long-range infantry. So, yeah, they can work great, but in that sort of situation, you will get forced away. That US mortar, it does pack up very quickly, so it's hard to get off those cheeky nades. Cheeky Nandos, cheeky nades. Good combination.
Yeah, certainly is, Machine. I don't know how whether they would approve of you throwing cheeky nades at cheeky Nandos though. The garrison gets taken out by the infiltration nades. Solid evac though from Shadow. Will avoid being taken out and losing the echelon squad.
Should work out well in Brosraz's favor, because then that garrison can't be used against him. It's going to be a bit easy for him to hold this VP. Panzer II is being built, but the Stuart's already here. I think we actually missed it, but it looks as though Shadowwater swag-pointed the supervise. Because it came out very quickly.
Yeah, it must have been. Yeah, it would have been a supervise.
It was in the base as well, the captain. So good play there by Shadowwater.
This should be a P2 cancel right here from Brosis.
Yeah, it is.
Fantastic. Beautiful play. Excellent. Love seeing that.
But again, he doesn't have any medics now, and that's going to be a big problem for him. The Stuart's going to be doing some pretty good damage, and Stimpite, still no Vet 1. He's actually close to it, though, but then it's just going to be chewing through his munitions income, and yeah, I don't know. Red Wings makes it work.
He does. Yeah, I think this can work, provided Rosas doesn't bleed too hard, and now medical crate's still not available. I think that's probably an issue. Rosas, obviously, the plan was to get those Storm Pioneers to Veteran C1, but they're not there yet, so he's trying to get there. He's so close. Chilling inside the garrison against the Stuart just to try and get the Veteran C, I think. Hit that Vet 1 for the heals.
I seem to be getting a bit of a frame rate drop sometimes. I don't know if that's coming through on the recording or not. I think that's because I haven't restarted Company of Heroes after like 4 games. So my apologies if there is that frame rate drop coming through on the video.
Puma's going to show up. We'll be forcing the Stuart away here.
Fighting position.
I mean, potentially this forces some supporting AT coming in here for Shadow Water, and Puma's going to keep going.
This captain here only has one bazooka. The Stuart gets a stun off. Actually, he could lose his Puma with the captain, but it's only one bazooka. It's not amazing. Main gun destroyed. Stim Pioneers, they have the Shrek. Fighting position going to be setting up. There's no MG. Loses the Puma.
For the church. Inside the church, but already the Stuart is out of range here, and the Puma goes down, and Bruce is...
Oh, the nade! No, the fighting position!
Oh, the nade goes off. Shadow Water, he completes the fighting position through all of this engagement, and then gets the nade off into the church and finds the wipe.
The rifle grenades from the fighting position. Yeah. What an awesome play.
That was a brilliant play, Machine. That was amazing.
Wow, kills that incredibly easily. But it's still there, actually. But, that's a huge blow.
Yeah.
Loses his Puma, which basically negates any reason for him to... did for him to go that tier 2. Stuart's still alive. It's 26 pop cap against 43. No medics. This game is... this is not good. This is not good at all.
This is going to be very hard to come back into. Going for a crit, and I mean, that's the only option here. Really does need that one to be available. Still, it's not going to be enough. I mean, I don't see Shadow Water losing a Stuart to a Raketen.
But the map control is in the favor of Brosas, so he could just call it an Osfin. Yeah. I think that's going to be his plan.
Has a triple cap here as well, Machine. 366 VPs for him, 459 for Shadow Water, but Shadow Water's starting to be bled here. At least for now, until Shadow Water can get the reinforcing and the healing done off that ambulance. Did
it's
come out after
off,
the Stuart.
So, Brosas, if he can hold off until he gets an Osfin out, then he'll be in a good spot. Because Shadow Rider's pretty far off getting a Sherman. So the Osfin should be uncontested for quite a while. Maybe Shadow Rider will get an M1 as a result.
Brosas, he still has one CP to go, so he's got to make a decision whether he goes for the battle group now or he goes straight for the Osfin.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually.
I feel like with the amount of squads he has on the field, that going for the Osfin is the best choice to start with some pressure going. The heals are necessary, but not right at the moment.
Panzer 2. See, I don't like that, and the reason why is because the Osfin can deal with the Stuart, whereas the Panzer II can't. The Panzer II would get stunned out, you can get taken out quite easily. The Osfin is going to be delayed, but I think you would give him a lot better late-game scaling with that.
Yeah.
However, though, this could actually be a dead Stuart here. Raketen's setting up, needs to get the Stuart forwards. We'll have one shot off, and the second one as well may come through. See if he loses it here. Is he going to get within the second shot? Oh, it misses! Unless that was an attack ground, I'm not sure.
I don't think it was. That looked like a direct shot. Oh, that is brutal. Oh, if only the Stuart went down, this Panzer II could have been a good choice, but now I just don't see it having any impact.
And now he's 8 pop cap. As soon as the Panzer II was about to finish, he probably could have called in the Ostwin.
No reason to go for the Panzer II.
He goes for his repair pioneers? Well,
very odd decision making.
Doesn't
here.
Even have any Stim Pioneers at all, let alone Vet 1 Stim Pioneers. So he's going to have a hard time dealing with these. The nade comes through. He at least has the repair pioneers on the way. I think he got those for his Kubel preemptively and got naded anyways. But yeah, Shadow Water. I mean, there isn't a big difference in pop caps, only 11, but Shadow Water is in a much better spot. He has some vetted riflemen with bars. He's only got two bazookas now, so he's got a second bazooka from the weapon rack, so I do love that. And
yeah, he's in a good spot. That's as much as you can say, Machine.
There's a few options here.
Yeah, there are a lot of stuff. There's a lot of stuff he can go for.
I think maybe an easy 8 Sherman would be good, because it's going to take him a long time to get the Pershing. Whereas he can actually just go for that easy 8 Sherman. He's not too far off from it either. He's going for another mortar. Does he have his tier 2? No, he doesn't. I mean, still will take him a little bit. He's got, I think it's 110 for the major, so then he just needs to get enough fuel for the easy 8.
Wouldn't be a bad option. The major, obviously, is that should be the next choice here for Shadow Water.
The Calliope is coming up pretty soon, but I just don't think Barossa has enough stuff, let alone static units, for that Calliope to be that effective.
It really doesn't warrant the Calliope coming in. The amount of squads that Brosas has on the field. Not that Shadow Adder knows for sure exactly the amount of squads, but he can hazard a guess for sure.
Even just the regular Sherman would be an excellent choice, the M4A3 Sherman. Because all there is a Panzer II. There isn't any Shreks anymore. He has a Raketen and some Faust.
Incredibly, Brosas, he's falling forward and maintaining map control here. I'm not sure how he's doing it, but it's a very good plan. The Raketen stealths up. The PG might go into this one.
The Panzer II may bring it down enough to two shots to kill it. It's so close.
Go, Panzer II, go!
There is a captain there with two Zooks, though, so maybe it's a little bit scared to chase him down. Oof.
The Stuart backs right away to the edge of the map here. Shadow Rider is not going to take any chances. So, Brosas, sees the two bazookas and goes, no thanks. Decides to back away. He's actually playing this really well, considering he didn't find the kill onto the Stuart and the Puma went down. He's doing a great job here.
Yep, so actually nading this mortar. You may get it too.
Wow.
Nice.
Good play.
This is the manpower bleed. Alright, so Brosas, he has a fair bit of resources now. So I would probably expect a squad of Jaegers and then start going for his battle group. I think that's probably his best thing to do right now. Because I mean, going at Osfin would be nice. Well, I guess he could go Osfin and another Raketen. That would work too, actually. Because then you got two AT guns, then you have two vehicles. Like, that could work. I think either of those choices, depending on how he plays it. The Kubel for the capping as well. Salvaging this Puma would be a good choice as well. Goes for the Jaegers.
a good choice. Gets onto the munitions point as well, which is an important capping location. Still being active with the Kubel wagon as well, making sure that the caps come out.
So what is Shadow Art going for? That's what I'm curious about. He hasn't looked at anything yet.
He can afford the major, but...
If he gets the Pershing, then that's going to be amazing. But that's it's still 13 pop cat command points.
Yeah.
So he can't rush that out. But that would certainly be the safest way of playing the game in the long run.
It's an M1 coming out here as well, so it does look like Shadow Rider's going straight for the Pershing and not going major tech here. And that's certainly a way to close the game out. Church has been destroyed now as well. Going to be hard to hold the center of the map. And it is actually an Oswin being called in here for Grossrus. He's going to Oswin with the Jaegers. Yeah. Still has other things he needs now. Battle group and another Rakete as well would be nice.
The Rakete actually set up. Oswin and a Panzer II could do some serious damage to the Stuart. Rafflemen barely survived that retreat.
Oswin at max range will have a fair bit of trouble penetrating the Stuart. But, this does mean the P2 and the Oswin can get some work done here. Eventually.
I love the bazookas on the Echelon as well. There's only one bazooka, but it's still worth having.
P2's actually going to be pushing the bazooka around.
Oh, looking for a nade. Didn't quite get it, though, did Shadow Arter.
Aswin actually avoids that one, but the P2 needs to keep being micro. He has to keep pushing this bazooka.
Maybe he nades the Panzer II. He may get it with one more shot from the bazooka.
Oh, no, he's cutting it off with his own Oswin.
The Stuart's there as well, but he's scared of the Panzerfaust on those Volks. Echelon going to be retreating. This should be okay.
Yeah, Echelon only going to be saved there by the reload of both the Panzer II and the Oswin. Their bursts were not in synergy. They were not ready to go. Shadow Rider now up to almost 12 CPs just from that engagement, so certainly
That was a great engagement for Shadow Rider. He got a crazy amount of the command points, but he has a lot of manpower bleed, though, so he's going to have the fuel, probably the command points, much sooner than the manpower. So maybe we'll see him play a little bit more cautiously, just hold his fuel. There's plenty of VPs. VPs is not an issue for either of our players, so they have the time to chill. We do have the Scavenger Arty as well. Probably the best Arty for OKW.
All sectors.
Yeah, there he is. No munitions either, so Shadow Arty has really been blowing through it. I guess this is all in his upgrades.
Yeah. It's zooks and bars and...
I was going to say, if he locked in this company earlier and put mines down would be nice, but
he hasn't had the munitions. I mean,
yeah, getting upgrades is always worth doing as well. And then that would kind of limit his options, because I think maybe Shadow Rider wasn't too sure what his plan was.
It becomes more evident as the game goes on. It's pretty clear here. And I mean, it's the logical choice from Shadow Rider to start heading towards that Pershing. He's almost there in terms of CPs. Doesn't have to go for the major takes. It's the most efficient way to spend his resources.
Yeah. I think what Shadow Rider really wants as well now is just to hold the munitions point, but... Yeah, Bross is actually been doing very well. He's just been so aggressive that he hasn't really been pushed off. And part of that is because Shadow Rider didn't put the pressure on. If he went double Stuart, for example, like that could have been a great choice. Double Stuart or a quick M4 A3 Sherman. Either of those things would have been a good way to kind of close the game out. But he's playing it safe, going for his Pershing. And
I'd say that, like, Stuart effectiveness has certainly been limited in their aggression by the advent of Faust for Volts. It makes it much more dangerous to go hunting when it might be a cloaked Rakete in the area, so...
Yeah, one or two Volts with Shreks aren't that great, but when you have four or five of Shreks, they become insane. Whereas one squad or two squads with Fausts is incredibly potent just for that extra utility in the snares. But then also four or five Volts with Fausts, it's not really good. So it's a bit more... consistent. You don't get that cheesy critical mass where you just A-click around one-shotting everything. So it actually pops down the Scavenger Arty. A fighting position for Shadow Rider. I think that's a very inefficient use of manpower right now when he needs to get this Pershing.
Yeah.
I guess it will give him the VP, but the VP isn't an issue. He's just so many VPs at the moment. I don't see why he's prioritizing VP when he has this Pershing as an immediate option.
It's rare that we see players do this well from behind here, and Resource, he hasn't let it shake him. It's awesome unit preservation from this point on. He hasn't really lost any squads, which is important because he just doesn't have the manpower to spend in that area. Has been playing well with the P2 and the Oswin, keeping control over the map. And he's only been bled down to 265 VPs, which I think, given the situation, is really nice, especially against the caliber of player of Shadow Water.
Something that I really enjoy doing is when you are going for Pershing, you almost always will end up floating up fuel. It's not necessarily that bad if you go tier 2, tier 3 weapon racks and nades. It's a lot of fuel investment. But Shadowwater has only gone his captain. There's no tier 2 tech. So he could have gone double Stuart and it wouldn't have actually delayed his Pershing. Not by much, at least, anyway. If one of those mortars was a second Stuart, I think that would have benefited him a fair bit. Okay, we actually have an M1.
Stuart's actually taking two shots here.
Oh, Rifleman dodged that, but doesn't move the Stuart away. He loses the Stuart here. Even the Echelon with the bazookas could go down. The Panzer II gonna be trying to finish them off here. Ostwind gets killed by the M1. What happened? It rebuilds the Ostwind.
Yeah, Ostwind straight back into the thick of things here, Machine. And there we go. The M1's actually gonna be wiped. Pretty sure that engagement went in the favor of Roisterous. Captain's arriving now, though, and he has double Shreks. But still, against an Osman and a P2, probably not the best engagement.
Yeah, can't recrew the M1. Can neither of our players right now. Damage engine on the Ostwind. Shadowheart, is he reinforcing his squads?
He shouldn't be.
No, he's reinforcing his Echelon,
reinforcing
at least.
Reinforcing one of them.
I think that engagement probably went better for Shadowwater because it meant that Brossus, he rebuilt the Ostwind. Whereas, scenarios is he built two Ostwinds,
yeah,
he's built
true.
A Panzer
yeah.
II. What is he going to do against this Pershing? Just lose. Rakettans won't have the penetration and the survivability to deal with a Pershing. What was that?
Was it the M1 getting dropped again?
I have no idea what that was.
Was it the M1 getting dropped and then recruited
again?
Yeah,
maybe it was. It must have been.
I'm not sure.
Because Rakettans die. They can get one shot very easily by the Pershing. They're not going to have good damage. Unless there's a bait over a mine and there's two Rakettans set up. I just don't see Roisterous having any chance of actually killing this Pershing.
Ah, Shadow Rider went to reinforce.
Yeah.
I think that just buys Brosis more time to get some AT out on the field.
Exactly, it does that. And the thing is as well, he doesn't even have his battle group yet. I mean, Volks do actually self-heal, though. Bear that in mind. I think it's Vet 3. Hmm. Yeah, they self-heal,
yeah.
So it's too bad. But his Jaegers will be suffering from that. Another nade on these mortars. Doesn't actually get the wipe there, though. And those Jaegers getting low is a bit of an issue because they don't have the heal. Obviously, Brosses get his battle group now, but let's see. Also, with the Ostwind and the Pershing, the Ostwind and the Panzer II, I mean, a lot of veterancy on the Pershing, but it could be a dead rifle squad here. Oh, the reload comes just through.
Yeah, it's about the third time that the reload on the Ostwind and the P2 has saved Shadowwater from getting squad wiped here. There's the engine damage onto the P2 will force a play.
Wow, Brosses was building a
less
Puma.
Aggressive. Wow.
It's also not going to really do anything against the Pershing. And it's going to be good against a Sherman if there's one, but there's not going to be a Sherman at this stage.
I mean, Shadowwater, he hasn't revealed the commander choice yet, as far as I'm aware. I haven't seen any mines go off. Certainly hasn't been any smoke, no rangers, no combined arms that I've seen.
That's right, yeah. He
so,
hasn't
revealed it yet. But, I mean, you can assume to some degree, I mean, it could be a Calliope.
Yeah, that's
in which
true.
Case, you know, the Puma would be good, but you would think, like, playing around the CPs, the Calliope would have been out by now.
A long time ago.
Had Shadowwater decided to lock that in. I'm not sure what he... And EZ8s as well would have been out probably by this point. And even then, Pumas aren't good that great against EZ8s, so...
He's just reinforcing all his squads, and it isn't necessarily a bad thing to do, as in delay your call in for infantry. But you got to remember, there is no counter whatsoever at all. If there was... There was a P4. There was a squad of Shreks on P-Grands or something. If there was a lot of AT, then reinforcing the squads, getting the map control. Okay, fair enough. But when the Pershing is literally unkillable to your opponent, why not get the Pershing? Yeah, you'll lose some territory, but you get it back. Mm. Just needs to avoid manpower bleed if you can.
Especially when Shadowwater's current unit composition can't deal with Brosresses because of the Ostwind and the Panzer II. He can force those off, but it's at the cost
a
of
fighting
manpower.
Position!
Oh, come
what?
On!
Why?
Please don't troll us. Shadowwater, I love you, but please don't troll us, man. Please. Please don't troll, gentlemen. We don't like it. We dislike people who troll us.
The enemy is overrunning.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, not a suitable investment of manpower, I feel.
It's gonna die so quickly to the infiltration nades, the Ostwind. That Ostwind getting very low, actually. Oh, this scavenger arty on this fighting position.
She comes down. Would have liked it on top of the mortars, really. I mean, the fighting position goes down. It was in...
Can't retreat fighting positions, though.
Makes it tough. Yeah, look. I don't know about the fighting position, Shadowwater. It's your choice whether to reinforce, but fighting positions... Not so much.
It's going
to
be great, don't get me wrong, but... They're not more important than a Pershing. You can have the Pershing in about 10 manpower.
Oh, no, mistake here from Roserus. He was playing so well, but going for a Stuka. No. You need AT, my friend.
Yeah,
you need
he's gonna
AT
regret that.
So badly. You will regret that. That's not great. Just, you got to look at the composition. Like, where are your big flaws? What can my opponent come at me with? And it's just any type of major tech or a Pershing... Or Easy 8s will just end Broceless right now.
Building this Stuka right now is pretty much texting your ex-girlfriend when you're drunk.
It seems like a good idea
at the time, but it's going to have dire consequences and you will regret it.
You certainly will. It's an excellent analogy, Machine. I agree with you 100%.
And the Pershing has arrived. Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. I mean, even if it was a Calliope, I think... Maybe Bros... Ooh, that was a nice mine.
It was.
Got three models there.
Okay, now Bros should know. He should know, man. He should know the error of his ways.
He didn't cancel it.
Infiltration aid's going to come down to the M1, though.
Oh,
they're
not
in range. The suppression means minus 33% grenade range, of course.
Bros has woken up and he's checking his outbox. Loses the squad of Vox as well.
He's checking the outbox right now. He's not liking what he sees,
Regret.
Machine.
Why didn't you stop me, man?
He's down to 255 VPs. He fires the Stuka onto the mortars, hopefully.
In before it wins in the game.
And this totally could, man. It totally could. Oh, that's a double wipe.
Wow. Dude.
That's a triple wipe, man.
His ex-girlfriend's actually considering it.
She's considering it.
She's
like,
interested.
She's looking at her phone. She texts back, okay, you want to meet up for lunch? She's like, you want to meet up for lunch, man? And Brosius, I don't think he was expecting this. Look, he goes to meet up for lunch, and he picks a good restaurant as well because he almost caps the mortar and will actually deny that to a Shadowwater. So
but he checks his bank
okay
account.
Here.
He's running out of cash.
Yeah. Okay, now he's running out of cash. Yeah. So he's at lunch, right? He's at lunch at the moment. Brosius is at lunch with his girlfriend.
I thought he was trying to like do his hair or something and look
no,
nice.
No. I'm pretty sure he's at lunch. Like he's at lunch now, man. He's just wiped three support weapons. He loses one, so maybe he. I don't know. He needs to fuel up his car or something. I don't know. He's at lunch, right? He's at lunch.
I think dealing with this Pershing is going to be... There's a lot of RNG with the Raketan's penetration. Do they penetrate? Because the things with the Pershing is it has decent armor, but its health is not very good for a heavy tank. So it can get taken out very quickly if you get good penetrations.
Yeah, Raketan's
but...
and even a mad dog Puma flank is a possibility.
Yeah, that's true.
You've got to be careful of the... Because the Pumas will certainly penetrate close, or especially with rear armor as well. So... Look at that, 10 kills in the first Stuka barrage. That's brutal. Will certainly affect Shadowwater's manpower. Thankfully, he actually gets the Pershing out this time. Otherwise, he would have spent a lot of time reinforcing and recapping his support weapons.
Yeah, exactly.
Look at this bleed. Bros is playing so well here. With the exception of his unit composition, he's actually playing really well. 235 VPs for him and 298 for Shadowwater.
Well, the thing is this Pershing... There's only one squad of Echelon for repairs. This Ostwind taking a fair bit of damage. Even the captain is there with the two bazookas. This could be dead Ostwind. The Puma gets a bit of damage too, so not very good targeting coming out of Shadowwater. If he all focused the Ostwind, it could have gone down. He didn't actually pop the take aim either. May have secured an extra shot if he did.
Not a fantastic play there from Shadowwater. Yeah, kind of switched up his targeting a bit. Could have got the Ostwind if the captain retargeted.
Okay, there's a Stuka. Not bad. Kills the M1 and destroys the weapon, actually.
It's a big blow. I mean, look at Shadowwater's unit composition here. Down to a captain, three rifles, and the echelon here. No repairs on the Pershing.
It's okay, man.
Fantastic.
He has a fighting position. It's fine.
Yeah, it's going to go down. The P2 and the Raketan should be able to finish that one off pretty easily.
Well, this Stuka is actually doing very well.
I feel like
we should put a disclaimer in. General gentlemen, do not recommend texting your ex when you're drunk.
Yeah.
We cannot guarantee that it'll go well for you.
But sometimes, apparently, it can. I mean, who would have thought it, Machine? Who would have thought it? Lunch is going well. I mean, lunch is going well, right? It's got to be going well. Like, maybe they just ordered drinks or something. Like, it's... Yeah. They're having a bit of chat.
If Bros just wins this game, I'm going to have to send Katie a text and be like, hey, how you doing? You want
to
meet up?
I think we just about have to, don't we? Like,
yeah.
Isn't that's kind of the way we got to look at things here. The repairs, however, are coming down. The defenses... The girlfriend defenses are coming up here.
I miss you.
Parashi's here soon. What are you doing, Brosis? What are you doing? Is that another Oswind? Bro.
Oh, no.
Oh, come on, man. You just shot yourself in the foot, dude. You shot yourself in the foot, I reckon. I think you shot yourself in the foot
here. Yeah, look. And I can see it working if the VP situation was very low and you could maybe bleed him out in VPs, but there's plenty of VPs left. Yeah, that Oswind was a bad choice. And there's no excuse for that because he's revealed the Pershing. The Scavenger Arty, though, not too bad.
Forces more retreats and continues the triple pap. However, that's probably going to be a dead Jaeger squad. The Pershings don't tend to miss.
Oh, wow. I thought the Stuart wreck would have saved him, but no, actually got through
negative,
that one.
So, not a lot of squads here for Brosros, and just a terrible unit composition here.
It is working, though.
I mean...
Somehow.
But it shouldn't be. General Gentleman disclaimer, wouldn't we?
There's only one Raket, and there's a Puma, and...
It doesn't seem like enough AT. I mean, I'm about to retire from shoutcasting if Brosros wins this game, and that's going to be the...
He kills the Echelon. Oh, my God. Is he even killing this Pershing?
Really
this
nice
Stuka.
Dodge there from Shadow White. A good game sense knowing where the Stuka was firing.
The Pershing is the new boyfriend. Or the big brother or something.
Okay. Something big and scary, yeah.
Blake's dad.
Well, that's true. That certainly is true. Oh, man. P2's going after Pershings. This is next level. Look, I mean, the one positive here for Brosros, it's hard for the Pershing to be on multiple VPs at once. So while Shadow Adder can stall this out, I don't see him holding two VPs.
Puma penetrates the front. I don't know what he's doing here. Raketan fires as well. Insanely good RNG so far.
Raketan's going to get another. Oh, my God. Man, gun destroy. What is going on, Machine? No. I don't want to retire,
I don't
want
to text Katie. It'd be really fucking awkward.
I like it, man. I really like casting. I don't want to have to retire. I don't want it, man. I like casting. Oh, lordy. Brosros, you are a baller, man. You are a baller. However, the Puma... Oh, you're not going
this. Oh, no!
You're not going this, are you? No! No! Did it go down?
It's going to. I think it's going to. He kills it!
No!
The Pershing is dead.
How? How is this working? How is this working, Machine? Shadowwater, he went major tech. He can't go for another Pershing. He's gonna be stuck.
Oh no, he's out of fuel.
He's out of fuel.
Oh God.
Can
what have I done?
Close this game.
He's building it.
What
oh,
is
no.
going
He went
on.
Major tech. That's why.
Because he went major tech. He didn't think he'd lose the Pershing, but
I can't blame him either.
I can't blame him. I cannot blame Shadowwater for that. I don't think you could have lost the Pershing. I didn't see him losing the Pershing there to the. The baller Puma just flying in, taking two shots against the rear armor and finishing the Pershing off. That was a baller play from Brosros.
Brosros, right now, he's thinking, okay, he may rebuild a Pershing. Yeah. Better build a Puma then.
Like, what is this? Did he hit the other boyfriend with this car or something? Or
maybe he has really good dance moves.
Maybe he does have good dance moves. I mean, I don't know, man. I don't know at this point.
I can dance.
My life is a lie. It really is. Brosros, he's on 233 VPs above Shadow Wanda's 167. He is making this unit composition work.
Vet 4, Panzer 2.
Bro, do you see a battlegroup headquarters? Who needs a battlegroup headquarters? Not this guy, man. Not this guy.
Stuka Barrage. Oh, no. Oh, that was a close one. It's the Sherman. There's a lot of bazookas here, actually. That is a crazy amount of zooks.
That's so much manpower bleed for Shadow, though.
Gentlemen, do not recommend that you kill Oswinds with bazookas, but it seems to be working just now.
Oh,
the single file formation,
it.
The worst file formation.
Nice kiting with these Oswinds as well.
This is going really badly.
Staying out of bazooka range. This is awesome play. Brosros is playing this super well, but the Sherman's coming in. Here we go. There's no counter to the Sherman, really, here,
that
Machine.
That Panzer 2 could go down here. It's almost Vet 5. It would be very tragic. He loses that one.
It goes down.
I think he lost a squad of riflemen there, though, and a fair bit of manpower bleed as well.
Oh, the Osman's actually going in here. That's probably not the best idea. He's going to be pushing the bazookas, but the Sherman's probably going
to
take him out.
Yeah, I don't understand what he's doing, but to be honest, I'm glad that Shadowwater's winning.
Shadowwater is turning this around. The world makes sense again. All of a sudden, the pop cap is coming closer to even. That's at least two tanks out here. Brosros, he goes for another Oswind.
Order has been brought to chaos, or at least we hope so.
Something like that. I'm surprised it's not a Puma, though. That does shock me a little bit, but Could Shadow Hunter lose more units here? I mean, the Shermans, you know, running away.
This Sherman could go very well. It could wipe the score to the HE, and it can still kind of deal with those Ostfins.
It's nice, yeah, for sure. And if the game goes out long enough, potentially we see Shadow Rider with another Pershing, but I don't think the game's going to go that long.
Shadow Rider's 135 VPs. Yeah, so he is in. Is a bit strained for time. Mm. Vet 3 Ostfin. I think they get suppression. Oh, no, weapon range. Oh, no suppression.
Okay,
it depends who gets suppression in Vet 5.
It's looking good. So there are two Ostfins on the field at the moment. That means, like, I mean, Shadow Rider, he can't split across VPs here, and with double Rakettans, it's possible that Brosius finds the Sherman out of position. What are you doing, Ostwin? There could have been mines there.
Could get the crew. Yes.
Mines the crew. One shot.
He's got Echelon in the Sherman, which is actually probably a good idea. I guess that Vet 2 out. That was in. So he was repairing. You get increased damage while repairing. At least on the vehicle crew.
That's the Arty gonna be called in here, and Shadow Arty, he doesn't have a lot left. He has to,
The
repairing squad,
if the Stuka killed the Echelon repairing the Sherman, that would have been.
Is the Stuka gonna fire or?
Didn't it?
It did fire during that. Oh yeah, I see, during that. I missed it because of the
It went here, so I think he was trying to get squads. He maybe could have got the ambo, but people didn't know where the ambo was. Yeah, I think Shadow Hunter's going to lose.
I think he might lose, man. The Puma's going to come in. This has been incredible play from Brosseras. I'm sorry I ever doubted you, man. I apologize. Even if you lose this, I'm sorry I doubted you.
Go home, Red Wings. You're fired. Did he lose a squad there? I think he may have done.
Here we go. The Sherman's going to be going in, but that's against double Rakettans.
Yeah, there's Faust there as well on the Vox. He actually has, I believe it's Heishi. Oh, Heishi ammo is equipped. Not very good, but a lot of Bazooka's going to be firing on this Osprey. He drives through it like a mad dog. Bazooka's going to be opening up any moment now. There goes the Osprey.
But it has gone down now.
It's a Vet 2 Sherman as well. Looks like he's actually got out of the arc, I think, just barely. Maybe evac out of that. There's no smoke either.
Should definitely evac this one. There's no smoke to come out. Well,
the crew gets gunned down.
Oh, the Rakettan goes down here, and the Sherman's actually still alive. And another Sherman being built here by Shadow Rider. He's down on 60 VPs now. Can he repair this one? Is he going to run out of VPs here? Brosseras, he can still come into this one. He's got like the Puma left over.
He can cap the vehicle crew.
He's got a
crew.
Triple cap. He's in a good position here. Down to 53 VPs now for Shadow Rider.
There are only two squads of infantry.
Yeah, two squads of infantry
GG'd. Oh, wow.
He GG'd?
Yeah, well, I think so. I mean, look, he has two squads.
Yeah,
he's got 50
VPs.
Yeah, I think he's going to lose that one for sure.
I think he was going to be over.
Maybe,
I don't want to retire, man.
Maybe,
do I have to take it back?
Yeah, if he sent that Sherman up the north here, cap that one, and then maybe, but even then. Okay.
I didn't know what Brosseras' position was in.
How about we strike a deal?
Okay.
You don't have to retire from casting if I don't have to text Katie.
All right, deal. Done.
All right.
I mean, I don't know how our viewers are going to feel about this, but deal. Okay.
I'm sorry.
Dude, I might even retire.
I probably would have for a joke, but she actually has a new boyfriend, so that would be weird.
Yeah, it would be a little bit awkward. So.
All right.
Oh, that just... Oh, Brosseras, you are the baller of all ballers. I mean...
What a mad dog.
We don't normally award General's Gentleman swag points in Company of Heroes 2, but, dude, you get like 20. Yeah, like 20 General's Gentleman swag points.
No medics, no problem.
No medics, no problem. Exactly, Machine. Who needs medics? Medics are so meta. Going trucks, too meta. Going AT, way too meta. Brosseras does not play the meta game. He plays the swag game. He plays the Stuka wiping three support weapons game. He plays the two Ostwinds, a P2 and a Puma, 4v1ing a Pershing game. He plays the
yeah, that was
just.
But again, it is good RNG because the Puma was penning, the Rakettan was penning,
Mangun
destroyed crit.
Yeah.
So unlucky there. Unlucky by Shadow Rider.
That's really bad RNG. That should not have happened. The Rakettan was consistently penetrating.
That was insane.
That was nuts. That was insanity. Yeah, that was complete insanity. And we thought Shadow Rider was doing the exact right thing, and Brosseras was doing the complete wrong thing. It's like, oh, nope, we were completely wrong. Which, you know, we're okay. We're okay with admitting we're wrong as long as we don't have to retire. Or
we shouldn't have been wrong,
friends.
Though.
Yeah.
It's like we said the right things, and I would say the same things again tomorrow because that was ridiculous, and Shadow Rider shouldn't have lost
that.
That
was a fantastic game, though.
Yeah.
Rip Shadow Rider. Shadow Rider always runs into games like this. I feel like he's one of the unluckiest go-to players, honestly. But Brosseras, he played well. And despite the crazy unit composition, he just had so much aggression. He lost squads and he's like, no way, I'm not giving up on this game.
Yeah.
Playing crazy aggressive, kept a hold of his VPs, kept a hold of his fuel point, and just did not give up on the game, which we've got to commend. That was
I think a lot of players would just GG in that situation. Yeah. I mean, I may have done. Because sometimes, even though I think to myself, maybe I could win, I just can't be bothered. Because you have that, like,
you lose that mental.
You get that frustration. You go on till, it's not fun. You just want to quit and get out of there. But hey, you know, sometimes you'll come around and sometimes you'll win. But yeah, we saw Pumas killing Pershings. We saw Bazookas killing Osmonds.
Yeah.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. All right. Well, thanks for watching, guys. That's game. That was fantastic. And a surprising end to that one. So thanks for watching. Big thanks, as always, to our Patreon backers for supporting us and allowing us to post videos full time. If you do want to support us, then, you know, please do consider a Patreon backing or a PayPal donation. All the links for everything are in the description. So other than that, we will see you later.
Thanks, guys.